Okay, so let us start to the class. Just we discussed in the previous class simulation of the single phase full wave uncontrolled rectifier. Okay, so that part we just already simulate the circuit. So just to open that MATLAB simulation, this one. Okay, so just basically up to this part we already done in the previous class. Okay, how we can drag all the element from the library to workspace, and how we just generate the workspace, new workspace or untitled. Then you may be rename of that untitled by the summer space band number of model number. Okay, so we already saved this model as model number 5, suppose that. Okay, so we already track all the remain in the previous class, so I'm not going to discuss about those part. Okay, so up to this point, that means 1 voltmeter connected across the output and 1 voltmeter connected across the input voltage. Okay, so just we add one parameters, that means Simulink library, just open. So this power guy just drag to the workspace. Okay, now and this power guy drag into the workspace. So just click on the power guy and configuration parameter. Okay, so simulation type is change to discrete. Okay, and sample time, that means we take the default value of 50 microsecond. So just apply and okay. Okay, so just this one is okay. Now next in the go to the simulation model configuration parameter. Okay, so this one change variable to fixed. Okay, fixed system. And this one select as odd 4. Okay, just apply and okay. Simple stripping time, I am not going to change this one. So if you run, now model is simulated, so just run this program model. Okay, and if you click on the scope, so you will get the output voltage. Okay, output voltage waveform and input voltage waveform. Is it not? Output voltage and input voltage waveform. So you may be set here value, the maximum value more than 300. So this value we can change from the this parameter, that means here. Suppose that if you want to change this value, how much we put here? That means already put here 230 volt RMS value of single phase into 1.42, that means root 2. Is it not? The maximum value we can write as a root 2 times of the RMS voltage. Okay, so 230 is your RMS voltage for the single phase, and root 2 value is your 1.42. So this one written here and apply okay. And here resistance value I have taken as 10 ohm. Okay, so we can obtain the waveform of input and output. Okay, suppose that if you want to measure the output current, okay, output current, so we require one emitter. Okay, so just go to the library, simulation library, and drag one emitter. That means so from this one, go to the sim scape and go to the sim scape, sim power system. Okay, sim power system. and application library means go to the measurement. Okay, go to the measurement. So this is for current measurement. Okay, so this is your current measurement. Now this ammeter connected in series with the resistive load. Okay, so just place here. That means place to this point. Okay, so just connect this ammeter in series with this one. Okay, yeah, connected, and this ammeter connected to the resistive load. So just up to this point. Okay, and the waveform of the current, output current, if you want to see through the scope, so just we required to increase the number of axes. Okay, so if you want to increase the number of axes, then just double click on the scope, just immediately double escape on the scope, and just go to the parameters and put here number of axes is 3. Okay, so number of axes is 3, apply, and okay, so 3 axes created. Okay, now so this emitter output connected in through this scope. Okay, now we just connected here. So if you run this program model, then just you get the, yeah, so this is the output auto scale. Just turn the auto scale. So this is your supply input voltage waveform, and this is your for output voltage, second one, and this one is your again output current waveform. Okay, output current waveform. So just similar to the output voltage waveform. Okay, so just you may be obtain the full wave output voltage. That means 0 to pi and pi to 2 pi again. Okay, so this is your output voltage, and similar to this output voltage, we obtain the waveform for the output current. Okay, for the resistive load. So you may be change the resistance value for different type of numerical, and obtain their waveform. Okay, suppose that if you want to measure their average output current and RMS value of current, or average value of output voltage measure, or RMS value of output voltage. Okay, so just connect measuring display here, block here. So we required for the measurement of current. Okay, so measurement of current. So for the same things, you go to the library. Go to the library. Okay, and for measurement of current, that means for the measurement of RMS, measurement of mean value and RMS value. So measurement of measurement of mean voltage. Okay, so some block we can find out here for the measurement of voltage, average voltage and RMS voltage. Okay, so how we can measure that voltage? Go to the measurement part, this library. Go to the measurements. Okay, so just click on the measurement. Just wait 1 minute. Go to the element. Go to the measurement. So if you want to measure the numerical value of current, that means RMS value and average value of current. Similarly, average value and RMS value of the current voltage. So we require some block. Just wait 1 minute. So if we connect one. Go to the sink. Okay, so go to the this one is your display. Okay, so here the value of, and again go to the library. Okay, so in this display we can just obtain the numerical value of the current and measurement. So how we can obtain the numerical value? Suppose that if you connect this 1 minute. Can we obtain directly if you connect this emitter output to through the display? Or we just connect one voltmeter? One emitter, sorry, unit. So if you connect, suppose that up to this point, okay. So if we run this scope, so we got here the value of 0.02519. Okay. Similarly, if one display connected here, that means we connect one display. So just we can verify this output. Average output voltage and RMS voltage by what we have tried for the equation through the equation, that means 2 Vm by pi. Okay, so just to wait 1 minute, sir, how we can just suppose that if we yeah, so can we just wait 1 minute? Okay, so actually output of this volt emitter is connected here through the scope, and if you run this model, so we can measure the input voltage waveform, output voltage waveform, and output current. Okay, if you want to measure, suppose that here, if you want to measure the voltage across the diode, okay, voltage across the diode 1 and 2. Okay, so just connect another voltmeter through diode 1 and 2. So just you connect. Here across 1 and 2, parallel across 1 and 2. So this diode, if we connect through the scope, that means you change the parameters. X-axis, number of axes. So if you create here 4 axes, okay, apply and okay. If you run this model, that means if you connect this voltmeter through the scope, that means up to here. Okay, so just run this model. Yeah, and click on the scope. Okay, so just for the auto scale. Okay, so it is showing not the exact waveform of the voltage across the diode 1 and diode 2. So voltage across the diode 1 and 2 is just showing similar to the output voltage. So I think something which we require to correct here. So their connection, that means voltage across the diode 1 and 2. So this is connected at this point. This is connected at this point. So we're going through this one. How we can connect this voltage in proper manner? If you want to measure the voltage waveform across the diode 1 and 2, okay, voltage across the diode 1 and 2. So just verify these things. That means if we connect this voltmeter, voltage across diode 1 and 2 voltage. So just showing when it conduct, that means 0 voltage. Okay, and when it reverse bias, that means showing some voltage that is negative half cycle. So how we can connect this voltmeter across the diode 1 and 2? So across the diode is 1 and this is 2. So if we rearrange this one, something like this, just rearrange the connection. With that, this one. Okay. So just so one terminal is connected up to this point. So just to rearrange in simple manner. Okay, so you move this diode up to this point. So just yeah. So this one is connection of the supply voltage. Yeah. So if you want to connect this voltmeter across the diode 1 and 2. So how we can connect? Suppose that if you connect to diode 1 and 2, that means up to diode 1 and diode 2. It is showing something in this manner. So now if run this model, that means that input of the voltage measurement block is not properly connected to the network. So just to close here, showing some error, that means now this voltage connected across the diode 1 and diode 2. Okay. And if you run this model, showing some error, that is input of voltage measurement block is not properly connected to the network. Input terminal voltage, yeah, this one is not connected, no? So just you connect the input terminal voltage, that means that's why showing some error. Okay, and now if you run this model. So just simply got the total output voltage, but we want to voltage across the diode 1 and 2. So when conduct, that means voltage across the diode is 0. Okay, and when do not conduct, so got the reverse. So connection of voltmeter across the diode 1 and 2 is not in proper manner. So just try to reconnect this one, and suppose that if we just to wait 1 minute. Screen is not saved. Now if you want to so how we can measure their RMS voltage and this by the block. So just showing here, that means we just remove this part and this voltmeter, go to the library, simulation library. Go to the simulation library, simulating library here. From this simulating library, we can go to the, suppose that this one is indicating source and this one is indicating sink. Okay, so I want to measure the current value and voltage value. So how we can measure the RMS and DC voltmeter? We can write here, if we take DC voltmeter no block is found here. So just try to search how we can measure the average voltage and average current, average output voltage and average output current, RMS output voltage and RMS output current. Okay, so go to the some block here, that means just check it. If you don't have, then control and measurement. So not in this part, electrical source is just like a various type of source, and element, that means element, you are showing some various type of electrical element here, block. Okay, so if you want to measure, that means measuring part. So here the current and voltage, voltmeter measurement and current measurement are given, but I want to measure numerical value. Okay, so numerical RMS voltage, RMS voltmeter. So this time we are not able to get the accurate block here. Okay, so just set some mathematical operation, you may be find out in commonly used block. That means this type of, here maybe DMAX or MAX, where the use of this MAX, just try to show here this. So just this mask drag to the workspace. Okay, in the workspace is our here. So drag the mask, that means from the library. So this mask can be placed here, and now if you connect this mask through this voltmeter output, since this voltmeter and this voltmeter measure the output voltage and input voltage waveform. So the output of the two voltmeter can be connected here. That means if your scope move up to this point and this mask placed here. Okay, so that means same quantity measurement of output voltage connect here, and the input voltage voltmeter output is connected here. Okay, so now if you connect this MAX output to the scope, so just change your सर क्लास ले रखे क्लास बोलिए आंसर अच्छा ठीक ओके सर ओके ओके जस्टिफिकेशन मतलब कारण ना ठीक ठीक है सर ओके सो जस्ट वी कैन सी हियर द यूज ऑफ मैक्स ओके सो जस्ट वी रिक्वायर हियर हाउ मच दिस टू एक्सिस कन्वर्टेड इन वन बाय दिस मैक्स ओके सो इफ यू क्लिक ऑन द स्कोप एंड चेंज द पैरामीटर्स दैट मीन्स इफ यू सपोज दैट टू ओके and apply and okay okay so just create two axes so one for the this max and one for this emitter output okay so just connect the output of this voltmeter here and just simply max output through the one scope okay so this is the use of max if you same quantity measure that means different type of you can say that number of voltmeter connected in your model that output of that model can be connected through this max and this max you may be change also this parameters that is only two more than 3 4 5 6 if six number of voltmeter are available here in your model okay if six number of voltmeter are available here so you may be change here and the only output of this max is connected to the scope okay so all the voltage waveform of the different voltmeter that means voltmeter 1 voltmeter 2 voltmeter 3 voltmeter 4 and voltmeter 5 okay and 6 are shown their waveform in the same axis okay in the same axis just for this example we consider here 2 voltmeter okay so the waveform of this voltmeter that means output and input we will show in your same एक्सिस दैट मीन्स वन एक्सिस ओके एक ही एक्सिस में दोनों इनपुट और आउटपुट वोल्टेज को वेवफॉर्म ऑब्टेन कर सकते हैं ओके सो जस्ट क्लिक हियर दैट मीन्स इफ यू फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल रन दिस मॉडल फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल रन दिस मॉडल and then just click here on the scope okay so again just go to the auto scale okay so here you may be obtain that this is your first axis and this is your second axis so in first axis we already connect the emitter output so here show the output of the current okay output of the current And in the second axis, you may be observe from this waveform that the input voltage waveform showing some different color, and output of the voltage waveform are in different color. So, but on the same axis. So this is indicating for your input voltage waveform. Okay, input voltage waveform, and this one is your for output voltage waveform. Okay, if you want to change their axis, that means this voltmeter should to you in upper part and this one in below. So you may be change their connection according to that. Okay, that's no issue. If you change their output of the emitter and mass max in scope, that means here. Okay, so if you connect, suppose that this emitter output to the second part and this max output in first part. Okay, that means this one is your output first part. Okay, and the output of this current, that means this one. Okay, and then run the motor. So if you click on the scope and you click on the auto scale, okay, so you are able to change the position of the voltmeter waveform, that means voltage waveform and output current waveform. Okay, so here showing again the this waveform is for the input voltage waveform. Input voltage waveform, that means sinusoidal of the complete cycle 0 to 2 pi. Okay, and this is yellow color is showing to the output voltage. Okay, output voltage. The same axis. Okay, the same axis. And here you may be obtain the output current waveform. This one, okay, indicating at this one. So you may be obtain their waveform according to this one. Okay, you may be able to display the average output voltage. So average output voltage is how much for the single phase full wave rectifier we have tried in the earlier portion, earlier class, that means 2 Vm by pi. Okay, if you put here the value of 2 Vm by pi, that means 2 into 230 into 1.42 divided by pi. Okay, so if you calculate this value in numerical form, then your 2 into 230, so 460 into 1.42 divided by pi value is 3.14. Okay, so 460 into 1.42 equal to 653.2. Okay, so 653.2 divided by 3.14. Okay, 3 divided by 3.14. So just 3.14. So this value is almost equal to 208 volt. 208 volt is your average output voltage of this waveform. Okay, this waveform value, if you calculate, so you may be thought this one is your maximum value. If you multiply by, so maximum value you may be obtain here, that means 230 into 1.42. So how much? this one 230 into 1.42. okay, 230 into 1.42, that means 326. So the maximum value is 326. So you may be observed this one is exactly 326, something is more than 300. Okay, so maximum value is your 326. Okay, can we observe from this waveform? Is it not? You can observe, no? So this is the maximum value. And what is the RMS value, output voltage? RMS value of the output voltage, we just earlier derived in the previous class, that means V maximum by root 2. Okay, so V maximum, that means 326.6 divided by root 2. Okay, divided by root 2. So this value is your every RMS output voltage is equal to RMS output voltage is equal to how much? That means 326.6 divided by root 2. That means 1.42, no? Root 2 value is your. So 326.6 divided by 1.42. Okay. So divide, if you divide this one by 1.42 is, that means V maximum by root 2 is your RMS voltage. So RMS voltage we already choose, that means 230 volt. So this one is your 230 volt, the output RMS. Okay. V output RMS is V maximum by root 2, that means V RMS value of the supply voltage. Okay, so this value is already we taken as the 230 volt. So this one is your 230 volt. Okay, so similarly you may be simulate the single phase half wave uncontrolled rectifier for the various type of numerical value. That means you are able to free to choose their resistive value. Okay, so according to that your all the parameters may be changed here. Okay, okay, thank you. So we just stop here and we will continue in next class. Okay. Okay, I'll just stop here.